lot of us depend on our cell phones to help manage our lives.
Yeah, but when severe weather strikes, we may rely on tornado sirens to help warn us, a much older technology. Tonight, our 12 News investigation examines the dependency on those sirens, their limitations, and whether too many of us have a false sense of security.
This is your community. When you drive through and you see, you know, ominous looking skies, I mean, is your mind on the tornado that you guys went through?
Well, I think it's always in the back of your mind.
Eagle Fire Chief Justin Heim lost his house in 2010 when a tornado tore it apart with his wife and kids inside.
The house basically blew over the top of them, but they were trapped in the basement and a lot of debris was left.
Heim's family, like others, had little warning because the siren in Eagle never went off.
And I called the dispatch office and I said, you know, can you confirm that the sirens were set off? And they said, well, we're trying, but we know that they're not going off.
No one knows why that siren failed. The high winds and lost power could be a cause. Failure is not uncommon in a system vulnerable to weather conditions. The outdoor warning sirens are really a leftover from the Cold War era. And over the years, communities decided to use them for severe weather warnings.
If there's like a tornado or storm coming through, I would definitely look at those sirens to go off.
Oconomowoc residents have to live close enough to City Hall to hear the one siren still online there. Six others still in the community went silent when the city pulled the plug 3 years ago to save $250,000 in needed upgrades.
They can't cover the whole community blanket with sirens.
I don't agree with that, actually. I think it's terrible.
While Oconomowoc still has one siren, neighboring Delafield has none. There's no federal mandate for a city to have them, but there are mandates once you do, and compliance can be costly. Costs forced the city of Brookfield to cut off their sirens for more than a year. Public pressure made them reverse course and spend $85,000 to upgrade and add one new siren for an underserved area. Emergency managers like Racine County's David Mack say taxpayers are investing in a system that may be obsolete.
30, 40 years ago, they were the only means of warning out there, but we have so many more tools today, from reliable NOAA weather radios to the wireless alerts that come on the cell phones.
Several years ago, the city of Franklin considered a reverse 911 system to replace the sirens, but found that those costs were much higher. So for now, they are sticking with the old technology.
County and the National Weather Service has issued a tornado warning.
You don't use your computer. This
you absolutely have to use this. This is the only way to set off the actual sirens.
Waukesha County dispatcher Jamie Bogie shows me the blue buttons they use to set off the sirens.
Nope, we do not set off all the sirens in the county. We just set off the ones we're designated to set off. There are some that set their own off.
Communities who don't opt in to a countywide system make their own rules for warning residents. And while Eagle's Fire Chief Justin Heim respects that local control, he says citizens who depend on sirens alone can have a false sense of security.
And ultimately, do they save lives?
I think for somebody that's outdoors, you know, in close proximity to it, that has that early warning, sure. Is it optimal? No, I don't think it's optimal, but I think given what we have to work with, I think it's, you know, the next best thing.
Now, sirens can only be heard within a mile or two of their location and were never intended to be heard indoors.